Hi, welcome back to our channel. Today I have got some exciting news for you. Accenture has just announced its hiring for the 2025 batch. And the best part is this hiring is happening both on and off campus. So whether you are just starting out or have years of experience, there are tons of job opportunities waiting for you at Accenture. So idhar job mil gayi to matlab ki life set. In this video, you will learn why should you consider working at Accenture, how to apply for a job at Accenture, and the step-by-step process of application. And at the end, you will get some interview tips as well. Accenture is one of the top consulting firms in the world. They have around 750,000 employees, operates in over 200 cities over 120 countries. Before you apply for a job, let's look at all the major cities where Accenture has its offices in India. Accenture offers something for everyone, as it offers a wide range of job roles in diverse fields like technology, consulting, operations, and many more. Under technology, you can get roles like software engineering, system architecture, and AI. Under consulting, you can get roles like strategy, management, consulting, and business transformation. For operation, you can check supply chain and business process outsourcing roles. And for interactive, you can check digital marketing, design, and UI UX roles. Now that you have a clear idea of all the benefits of applying for a job at Accenture, let's talk about how to actually apply for the job there. So I mentioned that Accenture is hiring candidates off campus and on campus. So if you are graduating in 2025, then you can get the registration mail for the application process from your college. On the other hand, if you have graduated from the 2019 to 2024 batch and want to apply for a job at Accenture, then you can visit their official career page. You can find the link for that in the description box below. Now, if I talk about the job profiles, then for the on campus placement, Accenture is hiring for two job profiles. First, associate software engineer with a salary of 4.5 lakh LPA, and second, advanced associate software engineer with a salary of rupees 6.5 LPA. For off-campus exams, Accenture is hiring for two main profiles, one tech and one non-tech. For tech role, it is system and application service associate for BE, BTech, MTech, MSc, MCA students, where the salary is 3.4 LPA. For the non-tech role, they are hiring for system and application service associate for BA, BCA, BSc, BFA, and BCom student, where the salary offering is 3.4 LPA. If you want to apply some other job roles, then you can visit Accenture career page and use the search bar at the top of the page to look for a specific job. For example, if you're looking for a digital marketing role, you just need to type it in the search box and you will get the list of job positions that are currently open. You can also filter your search by location, job category, and the experience level you have. Once you find a job that interests you, click on it and get all the important information like the responsibilities, qualification, and the other details about this job role. Next, click on the apply button to start your application process. So whether you are applying through on-campus placement, off-campus placement, or through the career page, the registration process for the assessment will remain the same. You need to create an account and fill out your details. After registering, you will receive your admit card. Once you have it, you will need to take a mandatory mock assessment to check if your system is compatible for the main exam or not. The final assessment will be taken on the same system. So ensure you have working headphones and a proper webcam. On the screen, you can see the steps to apply for a job at Accenture. So the step one is visit the career page of Accenture. Step two is the explore job opportunities. Step three is read the job description. Step four is start your application. Step five is complete the application form. Step six is to upload the requirement documents. And the step seven is take the mock exam. So now let's talk about some more ways to apply for a job at Accenture. You can reach out to the Accenture HR team directly. You can connect with them on LinkedIn or send a thoughtful personalized cold email. If you are wondering what cold emails are and how to write one, we have covered all of it in this video in the detail below. And here is a little secret. If you know someone who works at Accenture, then do not be shy and ask them for the referral. Referrals can help you boost your chances of landing an interview. Even if you don't have a direct connection, you can try reaching out to current employees on LinkedIn and politely ask for a referral. It might just give give you the edge you need. Lastly, consider participating in events and competitions that are hosted or sponsored by Accenture. Like right now, Accenture has announced its Innovation Challenge Hackathon, where you can take part and get prizes and even get an opportunity to work at Accenture. These challenges will give you a great opportunity to showcase your knowledge and skills. Now let's talk about the recruitment process at Accenture. The entire hiring process of Accenture typically takes about 12 to 13 days. The first thing that happens after you submit your application is it gets reviewed by the hiring team of the Accenture. If you clear this initial application screening process, you will move on to the next round, which is an online assessment round. In this round, you will be asked to complete a test that evaluates your cognitive and technical skills. It's your chance to really showcase your strengths. The assessment process at Accenture is divided into four main parts, and I will start by explaining these steps for tech job role first, then we will cover the non-tech job roles. So the first round is the cognitive and technical assessment. This is really important because it is an elimination round. If you pass this, you move on to the next stage, the coding assessment, which usually happens on the same day. The total assessment takes 90 minutes. The cognitive assessment has 50 questions that you have to answer in 50 minutes, and the technical assessment has 40 questions that you have to answer in 40 minutes. Both of these are multiple choice, and the good news is there is no negative marking, so you do not lose any point for the wrong answers. Once you are done with the cognitive and technical assessment, you will find out within 10 minutes if you have passed the test or not. If you make it through, you will automatically move to the next phase, that is the coding test. This test takes about 45 minutes and you will be given two coding problems to solve. You can use any popular language like Java, Python, C++ or .NET to attempt the test. This test is all about assessing your problem solving skills and coding proficiency. If you pass the coding test, then you will be moved on to the communication assessment. This usually happens 2 to 3 days later. In this assessment, the interviewer will evaluate your sentence structure, vocabulary and the fluency to ensure you can communicate effectively, which is important for any role. Finally, after clearing the communication assessment, you will be invited to a virtual interview. In the virtual interview, there will be an interview panel. They will ask you questions based on your job role, technical skills, past work experience and how well you fit the job. This interview usually lasts around 30 minutes. After completing all these rounds, the interviewer will evaluate your performance across all the assessments and the interview. Based on your overall scores, they will decide whether you are selected for the job or not. You will be notified of the role. Now let's understand for the non-technical roles. The process is almost the same with one key difference. There is no coding test. Instead, after the cognitive and technical assessment, which is still part of the process, you will proceed directly to the communication assessment and then the virtual interview, just like in the tech roles. By following these steps carefully and preparing thoroughly for each stage, you will maximize your chance of securing a job position at Accenture. Also, be sure to check out our video on Accenture interview questions for some extra tips to help you ace the interview and land the job. You can find the link in the description box below. So what are you waiting for? Take the first step by applying today and start your preparation for your dream job at Accenture. I'm sure you will ace it. Good luck on your journey to joining Accenture. For more details and specific job listing, you can visit their official site. The link is in the bio. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more career tips and guides. See you in the